This year we have presented our study, the EPIC OPC study, that it summary the performance of dual P16 and HPV testing for determining the prognosis in cancer of the otopharynx. So what we do is create an international consortium comprising 13 cohorts of otopharyngeal cancer patients, including 9 different countries. And we study data on P16, HPV, demographic, tobacco and alcohol use, and clinical information regarding these patients. What we do was a centralized individual patient data reanalysis, and we perform it at the ICO in Barcelona. So we do a lot of multivariate models to evaluate factors associated with the HPV status, and also we assess the prognosis with the different biomarkers. So what we do is divide all the population in 4 different groups based on the positivity of P16 and HPV. So we do have patients who were P16 and HPV positive, double positive for those biomarkers, P16 and HPV negative, double negative for those biomarkers, and on the other hand, we have the discontinued groups who were P16 positive but HPV negative, or P16 negative but HPV positive. So we finally, after cleaning all the database, end up with 7,702 patients included on the study. And what it is most important of the study is that for the first time, we can see that the prognosis is not the same for all the groups. We saw that the overall survival, 5-year overall survival for the patients having a double positivity for P16 and HPV was much higher compared to the group that have a double negative. And those patients who were included in the discordant groups also have significant lower overall survival than double positivity for HPV and P16. When we perform all the multivariate analysis and when we did all the hazard ratio adjusted by the different factors such tobacco or alcohol consumption on treatment performed, what we see is that, for example, for overall survival, the adjusted hazard ratio for the patients included in the group of double positivity for P16 and HPV was 0.25 compared to, for example, the groups of discordance, P16 positive but HPV negative, who had a hazard ratio of 0.64, or the other group of discordant who were P16 negative but HPV positive that have an adjusted hazard ratio of 0.65. After that, we perform also the outcomes based on disease-free survival, and we calculate also the risk of dying because of nodopharyngeal cancer. In those situations also, the double positivity for the P16 and HPV was the combination of biomarkers with better outcome. So this is really important nowadays in our clinical setting, because you know that since 2018, we have a new TNM edition, special for otopharyngeal cancer patients related to HPV. And in this TNM, HPV definition is based only on P16 positivity. So what we can say now is that we know that there are a percentage of patients that could be misclassified in the HPV group and they are not HPV related. When we see it globally, if we test only for P16, what we know is that 11% of these patients are not truly HPV driven, so they will be misclassification in the TNM. It is really important also that we make an analysis based on the geographical area. And what we saw is that in those countries where the attributable fraction of HPV nodopharyngeal cancer was higher, such as Canada, Toronto, that has an attributable fraction around 70%, the number of P16 positive HPV negative samples was lower, around the 1.52%. On the contrary, for example, in Spain, that we do have a lower attributable fraction for HPV nodopharyngeal cancer, cancer, that was around 12%, what we see is that we have a higher number of discordant, around 30%. So we also presented all the results regarding the percentage of discordant patients according to the different area, which is really important. So we think that this is an important study, this is an academic study, and we can conclude after doing all the evaluation that P16 positive HPV positive oropharyngeal cancer patients show the highest overall survival and disease-free survival magnitude of association compared with other biomarkers. We know that P16 positive HPV negative and P16 negative HPV positive patients have significant worse survival. We know now that using P16 immunochemistry alone is, we know that 11% of oropharyngeal cancer patients can be misclassified for the TMN staging system and also to be included in the escalation clinical trials, which is pretty relevant. We know that this varied across different geographical areas, but we finally think that P16 and HPV DNA, both biomarkers, should be done worldwide to assess HPV in oropharyngeal cancer patients in the clinical setting to avoid misclassifications.